I mean, even in math, this is a thing that I've been railing on Twitter all week. They're saying,
Can I jump in here? I saw you in a Twitter exchange about math, about, and I really appreciated this because I like when they're honest. And I think with this acceleration that's happened, this accelerating event, and now it becoming so dominant culturally, this belief system, they're starting to be a bit more honest about things. And one of those things is, you know, for a while, if you've pointed out to them that, you know, you're trying to get me to believe that 2 + 2 isn't 4, I would hear pushback on that. And now they're openly saying 2 + 2 is anything but 4.
That's right. And it's really funny. It's funny, too, because there's a plausible argument that this is my fault, because I started making those woke minis to make fun of woke people. And somebody was asking me in my DMs one day, it's like, would they really say that 2 + 2 = 5? And I was like, no, the truth is it's 2 + 2 = doesn't matter. It's as long as it's not 4, because 4 is the hegemonic value that's oppressing everybody that came from white Western ways of thinking. So it has to be anything else, but it doesn't matter what the other answers are. And so then I made this woke mini. I'm making these little satirical cards, you know, woke minis, and putting them up on Twitter all the time now. And I put one that was 2 + 2 = I don't remember exactly how I phrased it, but it's to the same point that it's 2 + 2 = 4 has its own definition is how I phrase it. So at 2 + 2 = 4, I was like assigning, hegemonic white Western value to an equation that excludes all other possibilities. And then the woman that did the 1619 project, Hannah Nicole Jones, quote tweeted it, made fun of it. And the next thing you know, so it could be a coincidence, but the next thing you know, all of these arguments that 2 + 2 doesn't really equal 4, it has to equal anything else, started coming up. So I might actually have been I might have caused that to have erupted. And then, I mean, this happened again today. Somebody sent me a thing where my own entry for science, where I'm trashing the way the wokes think about science in my encyclopedia on New Discourses, they quoted my definition of science from the woke perspective as though that's the correct understanding of science. Like they didn't, they thought that that's real. So it's like they can't tell the difference or they don't care. But then this evolved and some woman actually ends up tweeting in the wake of Nicole Hannah Jones doing that, maybe, or maybe it's independent, but I don't think so. This explanation was like, well, I just won't accept that 2 + 2 = 4. It has to be any other value, you know, something like this, because of the power dynamics that have defined it that way.
She's a mathematician, right?
Well, none of them are mathematicians. They're all math teachers. None of them are mathematicians. And so then there's this whole raft of people, and they're making cartoons. They're literally drawing cartoons, like trying to say why 2 + 2 = 4 isn't the right answer because it's limiting of other possibilities. And what they're doing is a word game. And I know we didn't come on here to talk about math, but we'll go into two of them on the cartoon. So they're like, well, if you switch to base 3, you have 2 + 2 = 1, 1.
Oh my God.
So that's not, that's
you're
not
fucking kidding exactly. Me. I'm sorry. You're fucking kidding me.
You want me to send it to you? It's real. I saved that shit, man. I downloaded that picture.
Oh my God.
Bam, that's mine. Keeping that. And so, but the thing is that 1, 1 in base 3 means 3 + 1, which is the same value as 4. That's right. What that symbol means. But they're actually saying no, because the symbol is different. You're using 1, 1 instead of 4, that it's a different value. That's one of the arguments that they made. So 2 + 2 doesn't really equal 4. Sometimes it equals 11 in base 3.
You could make that argument with Roman numerals. Like, I don't understand.
People did.
2 + 2 = people IV. Did. Like, what the, right. Sorry, 1 + 1 equals IV. Like, what, I mean, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. II plus II equals IV. Therefore, it's associated with drug use, and we're making a racist statement about how black people use more drugs. I mean, that's the
wow.
Kind
that
of,
was
like,
awesome.
Free association.
That was good of you.
It's
great.
A free. Oh, it's a totally. It's a free association game. So you just make this bullshit up as you go, and it sticks. So the other one they gave, and this one's a little harder, is that they went to modular arithmetic with residue classes. So I don't know if you know what these are, but they're obviously...
I do, but I think you should explain them to the audience because I don't think people know what modular arithmetic is.
So there was a pun, just like 2 meanings of colorblind. The pun was on 2 different ways to write down 4. The symbol that we usually associate with 4, the 4th key over on our number bar on our keyboard, that's one way to write 4, and then to write it as the symbol 1, 1, meaning 1, 3 + 1, 1. as in base 3 is another. You could add a third one, which would be 100 in binary base 2. We could cook up all kinds of crazy stuff of different ways to write it, but it's the same value. So in modular arithmetic, the pun is not on the symbol. There, modular arithmetic, we could talk about it in terms of residue classes or remainders or blah, 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 like we would do it if we were doing a abstract algebra class or getting into group theory. But it's easier to understand it as in terms of clocks, clock arithmetic. So imagine that your number, like imagine you have like a gauge, like your water meter or your clock, and the values that it has are 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3. And it goes around and around, just like on a clock. So on a clock, you know, it's to 12. So let's say it's like 10 a.m. and I say, let's wait 4 hours. What time is it? And you're like 10, 11, 12, 1, 2. So it's 2. And so you have to like go around and start counting over again, right? Well, here, if you had, say, the value 2 on something that's like, I should have done it with base 3, sorry, or with modulo class 3, not with 4. So we have with the numbers 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. So if we were at 2, we go around to 2, and then we add 2 more. What happens? We go to 0 and we go to 1. And so so the value of 2 plus 2 in that clock arithmetic comes back to 1. You can tell I used to actually teach this in math classes. Right. And so you can kind of understand. It's easier when you can draw it on the board rather than like doing your fingers in the air. But they're saying, well, in modulo 3, which is how you would phrase that, in the residue class modulo 3, 2 plus 2 equals 1. And the pun there is on plus. The plus sign means something different because it means clock plus on a clock that only has the value 0, 1, and 2. It doesn't mean plus like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, all the natural numbers. It's a different operation.
Well, modulo operations by definition have overloaded numbers because they have an end and they recirculate, right? That's what you do exactly. When you have modulo math.
So this is, again, a pun. It is a pun. It is a word game. And they're like, aha, so 2 plus 2 does not always equal 4. And what they're baiting, what they're depending on, just like we were saying a minute ago, they're either dumb or lying, and they're depending on people who don't know and are therefore ignorant to fall into the trap that, oh, wow, mathematicians don't know everything. Wow, even the experts didn't know this. And it's like there's not a mathematician alive who doesn't realize what's going on here and isn't already halfway through a bottle of Jack Daniels for having encountered it. Like your response, you're like, oh, God, like the second I said it.
I was a cryptographer for like 10 years, so I did all modulo math. Like, that's all cryptography, basically. So,
right. Yeah, ciphers and shit.
yeah. So, but they don't care. Yeah. They don't use words, James, right? They're not using words to correspond to actual meanings in reality. They're using words as manipulation tools to affect a political end. And that's the fundamental thing that I think a lot of people don't understand about this.
Right. And let me take you one step further back from that. They're using words in a way to create a fog of confusion into which they can assert the political end. So now they've got a double meaning on colorblind. They've got a double meaning on anti-racism. They've got a double meaning on 4. And then they're like, aha, see, white Western math just says that 2 plus 2 equals 4 and it excludes all other values, but here's a way that it can equal 100 and here's a way it can equal 11 and here's a way that it can equal 1. So all the other values are actually possible and they just didn't want you to know that. And people who don't know are like, what? What's going on? What's going on? And like, so what we need to do is introduce ethnomath that teaches this kind of thing in a more comprehensive way that you never learned. And I'm like, ah, crap. And then they're like, wow, maybe I didn't learn math correctly. Yeah, you're right. We need to have a better math class where we're not getting, we don't miss this kind of stuff. And that's what they're doing. That's the trick.
Well, now so that would be fine with me if they would just, if they want to separate and have a society whereby they operate under the assumption that 2 plus 2 is anything, and we build bridges under the assumption of 2 plus 2 is 4, that's fine. Mm-hmm. But they want to impose it on the rest of us, I think, is the issue.
The thing that they're angry about, which is ultimately that the Western civilization arose in Europe, gained massive military power, and then used that to tremendous abuses to conquer the world first, mostly physically with colonialism and then in imperialism, and then later conceptually and ideologically because their stuff worked. That's exactly like what would happen if we were to separate. And it's like, you know, you said, oh, they're going to drive on 2 plus 2 equals whatever bridges, and we're going to drive on 2 plus 2 equals 4 bridges. No. They're going to create 2 plus 2 equals whatever you want, bows and arrows, and we're going to create 2 + 2 = 4 nuclear weapons. And again, they're just going to, it's a right. march back to right. medievalism. But I say this in terms of weapons, right? And you're like, oh, I don't know if that's an uncomfortable argument, James. But then you change that into like our food supply chain. Do you think that thing just works by itself? Look how close it came to collapsing under COVID when our meatpacking plants got hit with viruses so quickly that it looked like we might possibly lose a year's worth of food or 2 years worth of food stock
yep.
because the supply chain collapsed. So when you have 2 + 2 = whatever, what did the white men say? Not that. When you have that, which of course is offensive, by the way, because people who were not white long before white people had any power in the world at all figured out the 2 + 2 = 4 and wrote it down in various ways and had very sophisticated mathematics. But if you're going to have that, you're going to have a society that starts collapsing. We can talk about it in terms of weapons, or we can talk about it in terms of functional systems that keep an advanced democracy around and working. It's like the internet and the fish sticks at the grocery store don't just keep happening if you break all of the systems that actually make those things come into existence. And no, it's not going to be better when you suddenly have 300 and some odd million people, or worldwide 7 some odd billion people who don't have functioning food distribution networks anymore. That's when our real, when problems unprecedented in human history start.